Yes, so in the previous video we had an introduction to interference of waves and we looked at constructive and destructive interference. Here I'm going to derive an equation for the resultant wave, right? This is what we discussed in the previous video. We have two waves, one wave one and wave two, and they're interfering with each other. The resultant wave would be something like this, right? Approximately something like this, right? And in this case, supposing you have one wave and the other wave is something like this, right? The crest and the trough match with each other. In that case, we will have no wave and we'll have a straight line as the resultant wave, right? So this is known as interference, and we identified that this is known as constructive interference and this is destructive interference. So what will be the equation for the resultant wave, right? That's what we're going to discuss in this video. So let us begin. Let us say the two waves, right? The equations are like this. Y1 is equal to A1 sine omega t minus kx. Let us say this is the equation of wave 1. A1 is the amplitude of wave 1. Omega is the angular speed, and t is time, which is keeps on changing, is a variable. X is also a variable. And k is a propagation constant. K we know is 2 pi by lambda. The equation for the second wave will be y2 is equal to a2. The amplitudes are different, so a2 sine omega t minus kx plus phi. Right? This equation for this phi is the phase difference between these two waves, because these two waves may not be in phase. They might look something like this. Right? This is, say, for example, wave 1. The second wave may be like this. Something like this. So they are out of phase, and this phi refers to this phase difference between these two. Now the resultant wave would be the vector sum of these two waves. So if I add these two, I'll get an equation for the resultant wave. So the equation for the resultant y will be equal to y1 plus y2, and that is equal to a1 sine omega t minus kx plus a2 sine omega t minus kx plus phi, right? Right. Before we move ahead, maybe one more point I would like to mention over here. Wave 1 has got amplitude A1. So I can write down over here that the intensity of wave 1, I1, is equal to some constant k A1 square. And similarly, I2 would be k A2 square. Because the intensity of a wave is proportional to amplitude square. So I2 is equal to k A2 square. K is constant, the same constant for both, because both the waves are of similar nature and are traveling in the same medium. Okay, let's get back over here. So I have to add these two. Therefore, I'll get y is equal to A1 sine omega t minus kx. And over here, what I'll do is I'll treat this as A, and this is B. So this is like sine A plus B. Now the equation for sine A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. Right? So I'll use this and open up this equation. So this I'll get plus A2 sine A. Sine A would be omega t minus kx. Cos B would be cos phi plus A2 cos omega t minus kx sine phi. Okay. Therefore, y will be equal. Now, in these two terms, I can take sine omega t minus kx common, because I have sine omega t minus kx over here. I also have sine omega t minus kx over here. Here, I do not have sine omega t minus kx. So, I'll take this term common in this. So, I'll get sine omega t minus kx common, into bracket I will have a1, and here I will have a2 cos phi plus, and I'll keep this the same, a2 cos omega t minus kx sine phi. So this is the equation for the resultant wave, right? Now what I'll do is I'll make an assumption over here. I'll assume that A1 plus A2 cos phi, that is this particular term which is there in the bracket, is equal to R cos theta, right? Where R is the amplitude of the resultant wave. R is the amplitude of the resultant wave, and theta is the phase difference. The wave over here, we have A1, which is the amplitude of wave 1, and A2 is the amplitude of wave 2. I am saying that R is the amplitude of the resultant wave, right? And theta is the, this is phi, this is theta. Theta is the phase difference of the resultant wave with the first wave, right? And the second assumption I make is over here, A2 sine phi is equal to R sine theta. So this is, we are making an assumption. Basically, we are trying to connect the amplitude of the resultant wave with the amplitude of the two waves, and we are trying to connect the phase difference of the first wave with the phase difference of the first, the second wave. Right? So this is an assumption I make, and if I rewrite this equation now, this equation based on this, I'll get y is equal to a1 plus a2 cos phi is r cos theta. So I can write down r sine omega t minus kx cos theta, right? Plus here I have got a2 sine phi is r sine theta, so I will get r cos omega t minus kx sine theta, right? Is equal to r common. If I take out r common over here, I get sine a cos b plus cos a sine b, right? Omega t minus x, omega t minus kx over here, theta over here, but this is cos and this is sine. So this can be written as sine of omega t minus kx plus theta. Therefore, y is equal to r sine omega t minus kx plus theta. Right? This is the equation of the resultant wave. Right? Okay. So let us look at this. Let us stay with this for a moment and look at it more closely. I have found the equation of the resultant wave, which is this particular wave with reference to these two waves, right? And it is r sine omega t minus kx plus theta, where r is, I have to obtain r with the help of these two equations, right? And theta is the phase difference. So basically, I have obtained an equation which is in terms of the first two equations. What I'll do is, let us call this as equation 3 and equation 4. On squaring equation 3 and 4, we'll get r square cos square theta is equal to a1 plus a2 cos phi whole square and r2 square sin square theta is equal to a2 square sin square phi. So if I add this up, I'll get r square common, cos square plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So I'll get r square is equal to a1 plus a2 cos phi whole square plus a2 square sin square phi. Okay. Even though there's some shortage of space, I'll try to complete this video over here. So I'll get a1 square plus 2a1 a2 cos phi plus a2 square cos square phi plus a2 square sin square phi. Therefore, r square is equal to a1 square plus 2a1 a2 cos phi. Now, here you have got a2 square cos square phi plus a2 square sin square. So, I can take a2 square common, in bracket I'll get cos square phi plus sin square phi, which is 1. So, this would become equal to plus a2 square, right? So this is the equation for r square. This is the equation for r square which we have obtained, right? Just because I don't want to go on to second page, I'm stopping over here, right? So I have got equation of r square, and I have obtained equation. I have obtained r in terms of, which is the amplitude of the resultant wave, in terms of amplitude of the first two waves a1 a2 and phase difference phi of the second wave with reference to the first wave. So I now know the value of r in terms of equation 1 and 2. So I can find out r over here, and I can get theta over here. So in that sense, now my equation for the resultant wave is this. I know the value of r, and I can find out the value of theta. Right, I think we'll stop over here, and In the next video, we will continue with this derivation and we will look at the intensity of the two waves, and we will also look at the math aspect of constructive interference and destructive interference. Thank you.